Okay. So, finally, we look at some work that we have done in our lab on characterizing these fabrics. And for that, some machines have been procured and installed in the LTS Systems lab. So, I will just showcase to you these machines one by one. This is a machine that we have for dedicated machine, special purpose machine for testing the strengths of ropes or fabrics. So, in the current configuration that you see, the jaw that has been put, this is the jaw of the machine. So, in between these two jaws, you will attach the sample. This jaw is currently meant for cables. So, you will see there are some turnings in the particular, there is, if you take a close look at this, you will find that it is meant for winding a rope. So, we use this machine for testing the strength, breaking strength of the tethers and the breaking strength of the holding lines that we use in our airships. If you want to test the strength of these ropes or these cables in a standard testing machine, you will not be able to do it because there are no jaws available to hold the material. Plus, the range of this particular machine is in such a value where you know it can calculate the property. So, I think it has got the breaking strength of 200 kilograms and the least count is also very low. So, this is used for tensile and compressive strength and you can test various types of forms. You can test round forms, that means a round cross section cable. You can test flat cables. You can test threads. We use a lot of threads in our airships. You can test wires. You can test fabric. You can test belts. You can test strips. You can test ropes. So, all these can be tested in this particular machine. So, if you have any requirement, you can always visit it. Now, as part of this course, I am going to recommend that all of you should visit the lab one day and we will try to arrange a demonstration session for you in which the students will showcase to you the work that has been done. Okay? This is one special equipment, around 3.5 to 4 lakhs is the cost of this machine. Then the next equipment which I want to showcase is a very special equipment. It's the helium leak detector. So as you know, helium is one of our preferred LTA gases and leakage of helium can be disastrous from the point of view of cost and operational efficiency. So let's say one of you makes a small airship or envelope for aerostat and now you have fabricated it, but how do you test it for leakages? So, one way of testing for leakages is go to the swimming pool and dip it in the water, just like the tire punctures are checked by the cycle mechanics. So, you fill it with air and the air will bubble out from the leakages. Now, do you think we can use this technique for our LTA fabrics? Why not? What is the problem?
There will be so large point force that will not be able
to. I am using air. That is very right. You will require huge amount of manpower to push a large envelope full of air because remember the buoyancy force will not come from the weight of the air, it will come from the weight of the water displaced and the weight of the water displaced will be quite high. Okay. What is the weight of 1 meter cube of water? 1 ton. Okay. Imagine. Okay, this is one reason. Any other reason? Why a cycle mechanic can use but we cannot use? Suppose I make a small balloon which you can push inside, let us say. I still cannot use it very efficiently for LTA systems leak detection. Why? I mean, what do you say? Yeah, so I am saying that now the airship is only 1 meter in length and swimming pool is available. So, still there is a problem.
Fabric might soak water.
That is one problem. The fabric normally not. LTA fabrics normally are not supposed to soak water, they are supposed to repel or resist water. So if I use, for example, PVC, there will be no problem. Raincoats are made up of PVC, so nothing will happen, water will repel. The problem is that a typical LTA fabric, LTA system is under low pressure. A cycle tube is under very high pressure. So the air is gushing out when you put it. Okay? In an LTA system, if you put it under very high pressure, it will tear. It's not designed for very high pressure. Right? The pressure inside, you know, is only little bit more than outside. So what will happen is if you push the airship in the swimming pool, because of the hydrostatic pressure of the water, it will just cave inside. It will cave inside, and that will resist the air to come out. So resistance of air to water. So you will see some bubble somewhere, but it will be difficult to locate. So you cannot use. So can you think of some other method of using? Can you think of some other method by which you can determine leakages in an inflated envelope? Now those from the LTA lab who know, let's not, you don't tell what it is. Think about it. You have made an airship envelope of, let's say, 5 meter length. You have filled it with air. Okay, the shape looks okay, but there could be micro leaks at some places. How do you find out? Think about it. It is difficult. We tried it out. We put agarbatti and dhoop flames inside. Okay, so first of all, it is not easy. You can generate, see, dhoop is something that creates a lot of smoke and it is easily available in the market. So you can put a pump which will suck the products of burning the dhoop stick, and you can push it inside the envelope. After some time, the whole thing smells of dhoop. So odor is very difficult. Now in which place you have a larger concentration of dhoop, you need a very, very nice nose for it. It's very difficult. Okay, so we tried, we failed. Anything else? Color? Color dye. So you mean liquid? Colored gas. Okay. So you are saying that we take a gas which is colored, and we fill the envelope with the colored gas, and then we look for places from where it comes out. Okay. You will notice that the rate at which the gas comes out is very, very small. Okay. So therefore, colored dyes also may not work very well, except when there is a big leak. If there is a big leak, you can see it. Then you need a special kind of a gas where there is an accumulation. You are assuming that the color will accumulate at the hole. It does not happen. It just comes out. Okay. So we have tried all these things. That's why I am very confident. Anything else? And just look at the practical situation. Now you are stuck somewhere in some college. You are going doing a demonstration. Now where do you get the colored gas? Are you going to carry with you? Okay. You might say, okay, I know some chemicals. If you burn them, it gives yellow colored gas. Then you pump that gas inside. It's not very straightforward. Think of something else, which is much cheaper and much practicable. Think about it. You have to use some innovation. Let me give you a couple of minutes to think. In the meantime, I am going to locate a picture of our testing and show it to you. So think about it, take some time. Okay, so there is a method called as a soap bubble method, in which what you do is first thing is you are assuming that the leakage will be only at the joints. That's not necessary. It is quite possible that the fabric itself has got a small hairline or a small spot where it leaks. So don't assume that the leakage will happen only at that point. And the method which you suggested it's possible. I'm not saying it's not possible, but it's not really very, it's very cumbersome.
Sir, we can fill the envelope with the hot air and over the time look through an infrared camera and we can record the
density. very exotic solution. So you fill it with hot air and then you wait. Look, you are in the middle, you are somewhere else, you are not in your lab. Think of a simple method which can be implemented in a laboratory. The beauty of solutions which work are that they are simple. Think of simpler solutions. Right. So, think of very simple solutions which can be implemented. Remember, anything that detects the leakage by looking at or sensing the gas or air which comes out is not going to work practically, because the rate at which it comes out is very, very small if the leakage is small. The pressure inside is less. If you pressurize it too much, you are stressing the fabric. I will not permit it, because you may create a tear. If there is a very small pinhole, you may pressurize and you may blow it more. So in the process, you will give me 10 more holes. I don't want that. So no brute force methods. Something else that can be sensed. We can drop a film of water. It's not easy to drop it, but let's say if I have a rope with bucket and that bucket is moved and the water is slowly falling, the rate at which the gas is coming out is very less. So you will not have so much pressure that the bubble will be formed. That's why, as I said, any sensor that detects leakage by capturing or sensing the air coming out may not practically work in a normal situation. Of course, what we do, look, I'll show you what we do. So, in our helium lead detector or the system that I showed you, what we do is there are two methods. There is something called as a vacuum mode. In a vacuum mode, basically, so you can detect the presence of helium. So this is a sniffer. You can see the probe here. This is a probe. You connect this to the machine and then you take the probe, and now you can move it at the locations where you expect leakage. If helium is coming out, this fellow will sniff it and he will it will tell you that there is a leakage coming, and this is a sniffer mode. Okay. But for this I must fill it with helium. And let's say there is a leak at three places. So helium is slowly coming out of that place. First thing is, it's a humanly difficult task to go all over the envelope with a probe. Very difficult. Try to do it. 15 feet length envelope. Okay. 1.5 meters dia. Just go all over the envelope. You'll be bored to death. It will take you 3 or 4 hours. By the time the gas will leak. So helium will, for using this method for leak detection means you should be prepared to be patient, and you should be and then suppose you miss it. So leakage is there, but you missed it. So it can be done, okay, but not recommended. But our engineers came up with a very ingenious method which can be used anywhere. It does not require anything other than what is available in a typical hostel. I will give you a hint now. In a typical hostel room, you have some things. You have a desk, you have a table lamp, you have a computer, you have, you know, calculator, laptop bag, scale, pens. That's it. This is what they use, and they can detect the leak. Any hints? Okay. So let me show it to you. We use what is called as a visual leak detection method. Okay. So what we do is, on one side of the envelope, we illuminate with a table lamp. You can see Vishal is holding a handheld table lamp. Make the room dark. On one side, put a table lamp or a big illuminating bulb. On the other side, the whole team starts looking. Now, light is something that can come outside the hole. If there is a pinhole, you will see star-like illumination points. So, on the bottom left is a zoom, 10 times zoom of one of the holes. So, by visually inspecting the envelope, you can find pinholes. This works beautifully, and we have used it. And this was suggested by some students who work in the lab when I gave them this problem. We tried all the methods you mentioned. We tried soap film method, nothing is happening. Whole lab became dirty, okay, slippery. Then someone said, swimming pool chalte hain. Okay, we went to swimming pool. Then they said, they all became completely wet and the balloon would keep bobbing up. And they said, sir, there is no leak, we are only leaking. Okay, then we tried all sorts of things, agarbatti, dhoop, everything. Ultimately, one guy chap said, sir, why not use light? And we tried it, it works. So, to give a technical name, it is called as a reverse illumination method. Actually, it is nothing but putting a light source on one side, making the room dark and observing, using human eye as a sensor, observing on the. It works very beautifully for small pinhole leaks, even when you are in the field. Okay. So, I can show you one, I can show you one image of, this is in the laboratory, this picture is in the laboratory. But I can show you one more picture where we know we it be in this. Yeah. So when we went to Manali, okay, at that time there is one picture here, I think. Yeah, you can see this is in the lab. This is the leak zoomed, and then this is Manali. We go there, we do our testing. There you go. In Manali, we did the illumination using the lamp that they gave us. So, this was a small hangar, and like typical IITians, we work in the night because we have to fly early morning. The best time to fly typically is 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. when the winds are less. That is the best time to fly. So, we worked whole night, and around 2 o'clock or so, you can see on the left side there are two students looking for leaks, on the right side there is a lamp. So, but this time we are doing it with gas. So, whether you have gas inside or air inside, doesn't matter, light will still pass through, na? Okay. Yes. We can't use this method. No, polythene material will show up, the leak will show up. Problem is, you must have seen in our videos, I showed you some videos of a black colored airship. It could not work in that. So, that was one drawback of this black. That was a very good fabric, by the way. It was 100, it was 95, I think 121 GSM. It was given to us by a company for testing that is this fabric good for your airship. And there was a dual degree project by a student. He made the airship from that. Very good. A small airship of 4 meter length gave us around 1 kg of net lift. So, it was very good, lightweight. But the problem is that that fabric, it could also be sealed by RF sealing. So, we could use our machine. But the problem is that we could not use our illumination method to calculate, to find the leaks. So, therefore, that envelope is available in the lab. It has many leaks and no one is able to find the leaks. Okay. The only thing available is our helium thing, but that's very expensive. Okay, so this is coming back now to the other equipment. So this particular, by the way, this helium leak detector is 17.5 lakh rupees, just this one small equipment, and the trolley of that, the trolley is another 0.5 lakh, 30,000 rupees. The sniffers are coming for around 5,000-8,000 rupees. Okay. It's a very expensive item, and I cannot take it with me to some place. So, it can only be used for those situations where we are desperate. We have some location And now we want to pinpoint exactly. So there we can search very minutely. What we normally do is, in locations where we get a leak, we put a red colored circle so that we know that this is a prone area. We patch it up, but there could be. However, if it comes somewhere else, this method is very, very cumbersome. Hence, it's not used.